Another day, another draw. I'm Stuart Hughes with your Bees Bulletin. We had to settle for a point for the sixth time in seven games against Cardiff City as the gap with Watford widened further to 10 points. We could have put the game to bed in the first half.
There's some space here on the right for Roslev. That's a terrific ball by Fosu. Roslev looks up, tries to cut the ball back. Here's a chance. Oh, it's an excellent opportunity there for Marcus Forst. He's done well first time. He's tried to place it in the right corner, but Smithy has just managed to save that with his legs. Terrific football there. A great cutback and a brilliant dummy by Tony. Force obviously got the call. Roslev took his time, cut the ball back just as he did against Preston. And Force has done the right thing. He's tried to go in the far corner. The keeper is half going the other way, but he's just managed to save it with his legs. Hopefully a little step over. Puts a cross to the far post and he's headed back. Big chance here. Oh, it's put over the bar from 4 yards out. Another big chance as Force has put it over the bar and Buemo's got his hands up in the air, turns his back as if to say, why, oh, why didn't you leave it for me? If Force leaves that, and Buemo is just passing that into what is basically an empty net. That ball's played through to Tony. Chance here, and a great save by the keeper. Very good save there by Smithies, who came out and closed the angle. A poor cutback by from Cardiff put themselves into trouble, and Tony was quickly onto that, looking to equal the record. And it was Marlon Pack who's closed down quickly, played it back into the box, and Tony, he's tried to beat Smithies on the near post. It was heading in the back of the net, but that's a brilliant save.
Kiefer Moore put Cardiff ahead from the penalty spot after 57 minutes, but we struck back 6 minutes later.
Fosu makes himself available. Ball just wasn't really strong enough there from Pinnock, but Fosu's done well. Then he goes to goal from distance.
Yes!
What an incredible equaliser that is! Fosu shooting from fully 35 yards out, and the ball was dipping. Smithies couldn't control it. It spun off his arms into the back of the net. It's one apiece.
The ball was moving everywhere, but it's a real bad keeping error. But yeah, when you're in these situations, you'll take anything. And listen, well done. Best player on the pitch for me, Fosu. Been everywhere.
Both sides then push for the winner, but we couldn't break down Cardiff's stubborn defence. With the prospect of a second successive playoff campaign looming, Natalie Sawyer's trying to focus on the positives.
It's a real shame that we're coming away from this disappointed, because it was quite encouraging out there. You know, it wasn't like the Millwall game where it was that it lacked so much. This one had a lot of pace, it had a lot of energy, it had a lot of creativity. We just lacked that final ball or that miscommunication that obviously has resulted in misfiring and things like that. So there was so much to be positive about from this one performance, but you can't help but feel really disappointed.
Thomas Frank said he couldn't fault the boys' work rate or attitude.
It's just another of the last six draws where I 100% think, looking at that stats, looking at the games back, we just created way more chances than our opponents, and big chances and unexpected goal and all that crap. And I know we need to go in the back of the net, but that's just showing me we perform well and should have had more. We don't. That's football. That's margins. So we need to keep a good head, good mindset, keep going and focus on the next game.
But it's just not dropping for us at the moment, said Christian Norgaard. And if it's the playoffs, then so be it.
Playoffs is a big thing in this league. I think there's a lot of teams that would wish they were in our position. I still try not to look too far ahead. We've still got 4 games left and we need to win them. We need to create a good rhythm for ourselves, no matter what, if it's playoffs or automatic. I know it looks very tough on the automatic now, but whether it's the one thing or the other, we just have to be creating a good form for ourselves before the last couple.
With 4 games of the regular season left to go, we travel to inform Bournemouth on Saturday with kick-off at 12:30. That's your Bees Bulletin. Subscribe wherever you get your podcasts from or listen through your smart speaker and get all the latest Brentford news first and fast by following Bees Bulletin on Facebook and Twitter.